Hey there everyone, I'm Linda Sharkey and thanks for joining me.
Here's a short peek at how we've enhanced our best-in-class point cloud tools for V25.2. We've made it easier to navigate through scans by showing the scan positions inside our bubble viewer. You can make the bubble a little bigger for clarity's sake, for example, from 200 millimeters to 500 millimeters, and then use the render settings in the point cloud manager, and you'll see there's now a visible only option in addition to on and off. Bubble views are colored green or blue when they're in sight, and they're now colored red when they're hidden by parts of the point cloud. This scan is a structured scan, so the visible bubbles are green and obscure bubbles are red. Just like in model space, you can double-click them to navigate to the next scan position. Let's move to an unstructured scan, and you'll note that the visible bubbles are blue here, but that's the only difference. Any hidden bubbles will be red as well. We've added a new color map, X-ray color map, that makes it easier to have better insight into the point cloud, giving us more parity and familiarity with other programs. Simply use the color map command and choose X-ray from the style dropdown. It works especially well with orthographic views and allows you to see how different parts of the building relate to each other. So in this example, we're tracing the inner walls on an elevation drawing, just using plain rectangle command and snapping to points in the scan. Then switch over to a layout, and there you have your inner walls. We've added two new classification models to Point Cloud Classify. In addition to the existing models, we've added models for roads and construction. The roads model is tailored for mobile mapping, and construction works best with aerial scans. There's also a new color scheme for Leica users who are used to the Cyclone 3DR color scheme and want to continue using it. I'm sure you'll agree that the results are super duper for viewing curbs, road surfaces, and other infrastructure assets. Another enhancement to our best-in-class point cloud tools is better geolocation of point clouds. When geographic information is available in the dataset, BricsCAD will store it and use it to set the GCS of the drawing. The well-known text, which is used to describe the coordinate reference system, is shown in the properties panel, and the geolocation property toggle can be used to switch geolocation on or off. This means you can now use the geomap and map connect commands in combination with point clouds.
The team here at Bricsys has worked hard to improve the ways you work with point clouds, but they've also added over 30 new and enhanced features to enrich your everyday workflows. So, head over to YouTube and check out our channel for more breakouts.